or Garry a valiant effort in the second half, but I imagine not too many complaints.
No, not complaints in respect of over the 90 minutes. I think that certainly a game of two halves. I think that, we always knew it was going to be very tough coming here. They're a club which got big ambitions of getting back in the Football League, good crowd behind them. And, you know, you come to these places and you hope you get through that first 15, 20 minute stage. And, you know, we started okay. We were okay. We were in the game first 15 minutes. And all of a sudden we get a situation where they get a corner. And it's probably not, that's disappointing when one of the lads breaks away and he's not been picked up by the marker who's instructed to do so. And it's a free header. So, you know, you find yourself 1-0 down. But, you know, as much as Luton was certainly in control then, going into half-time and had possession of that, you know, and there was a couple of blocks by defenders in respect of where they were attacking. But, you know, apart from one save, I think Aaron really didn't have too much to do in respect of that time. And we looked, you know, I felt, even though under pressure, it wasn't a case of, you know, too many major problems to be too concerned about. But, you know, we've had a little situation where Joe had a little spell in a 3 or 4 minute spell. We had 2 or 3 opportunities to do different things, and you know, the wrong decisions, I'm afraid, we finally got punished on. And 2-0 at half time, you have a situation where, you know, that was going to be a big test for us after recent away events, and how the lads were going to react to that, and how you come to Luton, who are 2-0 up in front of the big crowd, how you're going to, you know, go out second half. But it took us 5 or 10 minutes to get going in the second half, but the number one plan was hopefully to make sure we keep that discipline and stay in there after 60 minutes and make sure that 2-0, there's still an opportunity to hopefully, you know, get something out of the game by getting a break. And, you know, we had just changed at that time. We had just changed it and went 4-4-2. And within 30 seconds, we got a goal back there. A good shot from Gavin McCallum, which was parried away by the goalkeeper. And Joe McNerney, who we threw up front there on end and put us back at 2-1. And without a doubt, we had the best spell in the game that we had. I thought there was probably a little 15-minute spell there where we were moving the ball around and they'd loot and pen back in large numbers. And, you know, you could see the confidence growing in our side throughout. The supporters were getting behind us and you could hear that the Luton fans were getting frustrated. And at that time, I must be honest, that we honestly believed that we could go on and get, you know, a point out of the match. And, you know, it was one or two things that went against us. Which either they go for you or they don't, but we've got caught basically on a pushing one way, probably the man of the match for them, and rightly so. Andre Gray has worked his way and got a penalty in the penalty area, and they've put a 3-1, which at that time, if there was going to be a goal, I think it was us who without doubt who looked like we were in the ascendance and we're going to get it. But, you know, a lot more happy with the second half. You're always disappointed when you get beat, but you know, by no means did we let ourselves down.
Garry, I thought it was a game perhaps that was quite similar to the Wrexham game, first game of the season, where, you know, first half really, Woking struggled but hung in there, and then second half showed great character, got a foothold into the game, as you say, really could have perhaps nicked something, and then got undone again with a goal, and that sort of killed it.
Yeah, I don't know whether it's a case of, you know, you come to these big conference clubs, what I call big conference clubs, like Football League clubs, and you sometimes might pay them a little bit too much respect and play and feel a little bit in awe of the surroundings and the crowd because you're not used to it. But as I say, you know, we can't have no complaints in the first half, but in respect to the scoreline. But I thought second half, I thought we'd done very well. And as I say, we got a goal back into the game and we moved the ball around very, very well. And, you know, we were playing some good football, and there was certainly a great deal of belief in our supporters and in our players and management staff that we were going to go and get something out of it. But, you know, that's where you are. You're on a knife edge. You know, at 2-1, you know, you've got the momentum with you. You're going very well. You're starting to do things and players are starting to put a foot on the ball and you're dictating the game. And, you know, being fair, Lowick come on and put yourself about with Joe McNerney up there. And we were upsetting them. We were upsetting them. But, you know, that's the dividing line sometimes, is, you know, you're trying to get back to go and get an equalising goal and you run the risk at the other end of getting punished. And we have. But, you know, no way or any form of let ourselves down today or, you know, anything there. But, you know, we have to move on now going forward.
And great travelling support today, Garry. They made a huge amount of noise, I thought.
Oh, great. Yeah, they've always been great, but they did get beyond the team. But you could see the noise that they were really increasing in respect to the belief from the terraces that we were getting on top, and they were getting behind the team even more and more, and they were really playing their part. And I think that, you know, anybody in the ground at the time when it was at 2-1 and when we were on control and on top of the game, would probably have turned and said, who's going to score next? I think people would have, you know, without doubt, a large majority would have turned and said, without us, you know, being that team was a bit of a surprise.
And a big game coming up on Saturday against Braintree Town away, assuming it's on, of course, given the state of their pitch.
Well, you know, it is a big game, and they're all big games, as we all know, that in this league. And it's a very, very thin line between being sitting mid-table and having a couple of wins and pushing on higher, or, you know, a couple of defeats, and all of a sudden it's very uncomfortable when you're looking very close over your shoulder. But it is a big match, there's no doubt about that. Braintree beat us down our place earlier in the season. I think it was a scoreline that flattered them that day. But, you know, I don't think that the pitch will be pretty, there's no doubt. It's not the best playing surface in the world down there at Braintree. But, you know, we have to prepare for that. And I'm sure that if we play like we did in the second half and show the character that we showed in the second half, we're confident we can go and get results.
Lovely. Thank you very much, Garry.
Cheers.